Hey guys, and welcome to Black Games, and today we're gonna play Game of Thrones. Telltale Games, Game of Thrones. Oh, I've been excited for this for, I don't know, I remember when I played The Wolf Among Us. They announced they're gonna make Game of Thrones, and I've just been excited. Oh my god, okay. Whew. Yeah. Let's play this. I have been watching every Game of Thrones episode, so I pretty know what who this guy is and who she is. Let's go. Let's just play. I'm gonna show.
The great Jaime Lannister, Kingslayer, Oathbreaker, brought to his knees by the men of the North.
And set free by the women. You'd think he'd done it himself the way he tells it. Lord Forrester's sword won't clean itself, you know.
So I'm this guy? Okay, I'm gonna pick it up.
Make sure it's spotless this time. Old Forrester won't be happy with blood and brick.
Yeah.
Now that is a proper sword.
I'll have one like it myself.
That was easy.
You? You'll never have a sword like that. I say that as a friend. And if we're being honest, we are just a squire.
Why not?
They don't give swords like that to pig farmers.
Oh, he's a pig farmer.
I had a hand in it, you know.
Hand him what?
Capturing him!
He was nowhere near the Kingslayer at the Whispering Wood. He was so drunk, he barely made it out of his tent. Next, he'll tell us he caught Tyrion, too.
So what really happened?
Someone caught him, I suppose. Ask any man here and they'll say it was them.
You captured the Kingslayer?
Aye. Well, I had a hand in it.
Aye. And round his ankle as 10 others took him down.
See? What did I tell you?
Brought him to his
knees. Oh, I thought we were going to fall on one of the
not
main
before
characters.
Before he dragged you halfway across the battlefield on your face.
You're questioning Norrin's honor.
Ooh. I'm questioning Norrin's story, which grows more far-fetched every time he tells it.
Get your liege lord some wine.
Go on.
Don't tell me what to do.
I don't take orders from you.
Yeah.
No, but you take orders from him. You idiot, you're his squire. Now fetch him some wine.
I'm just an errand boy.
I'll do it.
Huh.
Norrin's family has faithfully served House Forrester for centuries. His honor is beyond reproach, and House Tully is forever in his debt. They've never seen a field plowed so well as the day the Kingslayer dragged poor Norrin across the battlefield.
So funny.
That's your cup. The night we celebrate.
Oh, I'm gonna get drunk. Yeah.
To Robb Stark, the King in the North.
The King in the North!
Tomorrow, we march on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honor to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard.
Yeah.
Lots of favors.
Onward! To Casterly Rock!
Death to the Lannisters!
Winter is coming!
Winter is coming!
Yeah!
Let's hope he waits till this bloody war's over.
Got it.
Winter's coming!
Yes, my lord?
What would happen if I choose something else?
To keep an eye out for Roderick. As his father, I could not be more proud of the man he's become. On a night like this, men find false courage at the bottom of their cups. I'd rather he were here.
Yes, my lord.
There's also the question, what's to be done with you? It's
what?
Been on my mind for a while now.
What
something
do you mean?
Must be done.
What do you mean?
You've served House Forrester well for several years now, but I can't expect you to squire forever.
But make me a soldier.
How shall I reward your loyalty?
Give me money.
What can I offer you?
Let me fight
for you, my lord.
You've more than proven your ability on the battlefield. No man would question that. There were those who had their doubts when your uncle put forth your name as my squire. But you've erased those doubts entirely. It would be an honor to see you riding by Roderick's side in the vanguard tomorrow.
Really?
Not as a squire, but as the equal of any man who serves House Forrester.
Cool.
It's well deserved, Garrett.
Thank you, my lord. I promise. I won't let you down.
That I don't doubt. But for now, keep this between us. We're celebrating tonight. I wouldn't want the other squires to feel discouraged.
Yes, my lord.
Now go and find Roderick if you can.
I will, my lord. Thank you.
She is nice.
Bloody hell.
Empty. Squire, fetch us more wine.
Can you give me a hand? Come on. Can I get up to you?
Okay.
Fine, but you owe me.
Owe you? I've been a squire longer than you have. I outrank you.
Really? Oh, I could probably have talked to him.
Yeah. Scrubbed my armor, cleaned my boots. Just my luck to end up with Norin while you serve the Lord. Let him fetch his own wine for
Shut up. It could be.
He's a drunk, a liar, and an arrogant prick.
You'd better watch your tongue, Bowen. It could be much worse.
What the fuck do you know about it? Nothing is worse than Norin. See, that's where you're lucky. Low expectations. If I'd grown up covered in pig shit, shovel and slop, well, maybe I'd think saddling his horse was the greatest honor in the Seven Kingdoms. I suppose this beats pig farming.
Who doesn't love bacon?
Ah, pig farmers. All I'm saying is, at this rate, we'll never be more than this, which is nothing. The lowest of the low. For all I know, we could be squires for life. All in wine around a fucking wedding.
Not me.
What?
Tomorrow I ride with Roderick and Lord Forrester.
Sir Gerard the fucking Great.
Maybe if my uncle were
Castellan, I'd be getting promoted too.
Who my uncle is, that's nothing to do with it.
He's got Lord Forrester's ear, doesn't he? I'm sure it didn't hurt.
How much further?
Yeah, oh my god.
It's right over there.
Take your time. Some of the animation look hand drawn. It's kind of cool.
You lot have drunk your share. Good thing Lord Walder's in a generous mood.
Fucking phrase.
What the fuck?
Nice night for a wedding. Not often he finds a willing husband for one of his daughters.
Don't expect me to carry it for you, Sir Gerard.
What's wrong? What's gotten into you? You're acting rather odd.
We need to get back.
Yeah, it's not good.
They can wait.
No, you don't understand.
We need to go.
And take the fucking flagon already.
I think the...
What's wrong
with
him?
My god, something's going...
Something the matter? Bowen, we have to go.
You go if you're in such a rush.
Shit.
But what about... What the hell was that about? Slow down, would you?
What's Run!
The rush? Run!
Thank God. Oh my god.
We need to get back to camp.
That was close. Jesus fucking Christ.
Run, Brian!
Garrett, we have to get back.
Oh, he will be fine. He will be fine.
The king.
What?
Ah!
Oh my god.
Ready, boys! Whoa! Shoot that one!
What a king! No control over my inner life. Jesus.
Garrett, did you find Roderick?
Stay.
Speak up, Garrett.
Hey, he's gone, my lord. There was nothing I could do.
Find a weapon, quickly!
Come on, take it. Ooh!
Walterfrey, you fucking traitor! Go, my lord, while there's still time!
Did you just got an arrow in the chest? What the fuck? I didn't even get a weapon. No.
Seven hells.
We have to keep moving, my lord. But
I'd never make it. They'll hunt us down like dogs.
Walter Frey says time to go.
Hey, he's not gonna make it. Give
Garbage
me the sword.
With your life. Return it to Ironrath, where it belongs. There's no time to waste. I'll be damned if I let it fall into the hands of those traitors.
Well, the Frey says
you have to go.
You're welcome to the fucking torch.
I will do as you command, my lord.
You have served me well. I know I can count on you. Tell your uncle. Tell him. The North Grove must never be lost. Tell no one but him.
Windows,
do you understand? You must swear. Tell only your uncle Duncan.
I swear that I will, my lord.
Hey, it's those foresters.
Now go. On your honor, you must do this for your house. Go!
Kill those fucking foresters!
Foresters. Oh my god. Where is head? Run, you idiot. Call that running? Oh, there's blood.
Blood.
Maybe we go in the wrong direction.
Fresh.
What the? What the heck? Did someone kill him? Oh, maybe we shouldn't go to Oscar. But we're gonna do it anyway. Yep, we're gonna do it because the story demands it. We're gonna go towards the fire.
That's Father's car.
Oh, he lives there? Oh, he was a pig farm. Oh my god.
Lord Bolton better give us fucking titles for this.
Winter may be coming, but at least still have his bacon.
God damn it. Oh my god. Should I go to Austin? I should probably. I wouldn't go to Austin.
Move along, boy. There's nothing for you here.
Father.
I said move on. Unless you want to get fed to the fucking pigs. I recognize you. You're a forester, squire. Former Stark bannermen have no claim on land anymore. Or haven't you heard? The Starks are dead.
No. Oh, was it that time? Oh my god.
Where'd you get that sword? Not a chance that sword is his. Must have stolen it. Out here by himself. Probably a deserter.
None of your business.
None of your fucking business.
Oh. Damn, he's tough.
We're gonna feed you to the fucking pigs.
No, you're not. Because my sword is big as fuck.
That sword's too big for you, boy. You can barely pick it up.
Get off my land!
This is Bolton land now, boy. Lord Bolton is the new Warden of the North.
Lord Bolton?
I reckon he'd like a proper lordly sword like that.
Oh,
no. I'll have that sword, boy.
No, you don't. No, come and get it.
You bastard.
Okay, I'm not good. That sucks.
Finish this fucking pig farmer. Pathetic. You really are a pig farmer, aren't you?
I'm gonna take this. Serious? Oh, not in the leg.
Mercy, please, I beg of you.
Shall I, Mercy?
I have a family. They'll never survive without me. I have no quarrel with you. I was only following orders.
Okay, I'm showing mercy. I can't do it.
Thank you.
Lord Whitehill will see you hang for this. That much I promise.
Maybe I shouldn't do that. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't kill him.
Father?
Garrett! You survived.
Seems surprised.
Your sister. Oh, she hid.
She, what? No.
I tried to stop them.
No, is he dead? Oh my god. Those bastards, should I kill them?
I'll kill the men who did this.
It's Garrett! Get the Castellan! Tell him his nephew survived!
Some sort of survive. Got stabbed in the leg, survive. Damn, look at
Garrett!
I was too late. They were already dead.
Bring the Maester! Meet us in the Great Hall! Quickly!
Two Whitehill soldiers?
And a Bolton. They killed my family. And for what?
Those fuckers.
My sister, she was only 8 years old.
This never would have happened with the Starks in power. Mm. It's unimaginable. Unacceptable. You have my condolences.
Thank you, Maester.
Fucking sir.
The blade cut deep, but I should be able to save your leg. Your justice was swift. Some will call it vengeance. No doubt the Whitehills will claim it was murder. It was your family. I can't say I would have done any different than you.
They attacked me. I had no choice but to defend myself.
Of course. Duh. And we can't let the Whitehills just walk all over us. These maggots ought to help prevent infection.
Doesn't he look like Luke from Walking Dead? I think he looks like Luke, a little bit. Why are you doing that?
These are dark days, I fear. To lose the Lord of the House and the eldest son through such a despicable act of treachery and betrayal. Greater houses than ours have fallen in times such as this. The late Lord Forrester was a good man. And poor Roderick. A serious man, but he would have made a good lord.
Roderick and Lord Forrester. We can avenge them.
And attack House Frey. Now is the time to find allies, not enemies. The future of this house is in Lord Ethan's hands now. Although he is young and altogether unprepared to lead.
As long as not King Joffrey, I'm glad.
Right. This might hurt a bit. Hold this for me, will you? I understand from your uncle that Lord Forrester saved your life.
He did.
Rather odd, though, that he chose to save you, Squire, and not his son, Roderick.
That's kind of weird.
Not that Roderick couldn't handle himself. He was as good with a sword as any man I've seen. It's unfortunate the Citadel doesn't train maesters in the art of warcraft.
Roderick had already fallen. There was nothing we could do.
Well, I'd imagine Lord Forrester would sacrifice himself to save anyone from his house, high or low. Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me first, to see if you can put any weight on that leg.
Seems fine.
Go on. Don't stop now. It's better to let the blood circulate.
And also give me an excuse to walk around and look at stuff. Forest. Let's look at the window. That's kind of interesting. Just to see what's out there.
The Ironwood Grove.
Yes? Okay. Well, what's the point of that? I don't know. Move around. Move. Oh my gosh, should we go up again?
Mira. Still in King's Landing, I suppose. Although, I wonder if they'll bring her home.
Probably not.
Talia and Ethan. I suppose Lord Ethan now. Asher. Exiled to Essos, unfortunately. Lady Forrester. She's always been kind to me. Treated me like I was a Forrester myself. Ryan. Never easy being the fourth-born son.
No.
Lord Forrester. It was an honor to squire for him. Gregor the Good.
You seem to be favoring it. Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
I'm fine.
Ew. Young her.
This might help.
Wait, can I just take it? Okay, I just take it. This might help. Whatever. Yeah, I should take everything. I even should take the bucket with magnets.
Rather cute little creatures, aren't they?
You're kind of disgusting.
I may be mistaken. You do seem able to put weight on it. It's a good thing you've done, bringing that back to House Forrester. By right, that belongs to Lord Ethan now.
Of course.
That sword has been handed down through 50 generations of Forresters.
It's also so big.
Did your leg feel weak?
No. I just wanted to ask you.
I know who's the new lord of the house. Can I leave
can
now?
Can I go now?
I believe your leg will be fine. Only time will tell, but... Lady Forrester.
Welcome home, Garrett. We're all relieved to know you survived.
Thank you, my lady.
Talia asked to see you.
Garrett, I heard what happened. Is it true?
Yeah.
Your family... I'm so sorry.
Me too.
Off to bed now.
Yeah.
Hurry on.
This is too sad.
Garrett was just telling me how valiantly Lord Forrester fought to the end. Even when all was lost. I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
He was a hero, my lady. The bravest man on the battlefield by far.
Yet he was unable to save his own son.
Oh, shut up.
You were with Roderick, no?
I'm trying to be
I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember anything, I'm sure Lady Forrester would like to know.
I'm sorry, my lady. Nothing could be done to save him.
He was House Forrester's best.
This has been so incredibly difficult for us, especially the children. But I was told you were the last to see my husband alive.
Yes, my lady.
I know it may be difficult to remember, but if I may ask, was there anything he said?
Oh, I can't
tell. Any last words before he passed, if you can remember?
Hey. Said he loved you.
That's very kind of you to say.
Aww, I just laughed to her face.
You have the Forrester sword.
Yeah.
This belongs with Ethan now. He's the new lord of the house.
Thank you, Garrett.
Of course, my lady.
It demands a response. It's too dangerous, especially now. Now is the time to...
Oh my god.
I'll be sure it's given to Ethan.
Thank you, it's too big.
Duncan,
This was reason. Our land. They were our people. Your family.
I share your outrage, Sir Roiland. I do. But now is not the time to provoke the White Hills. Not with Ramsay Snow coming to see us bend the knee.
The hell
bend
with Ramsay Snow, that bastard.
Garrett, you understand what this means. You killed a Bolton, and Ramsay Snow will want his retribution.
Ramsay Snow?
We're the ones that should be demanding retribution. This happened on Forrester land.
They attacked me.
Yeah.
And they'll say they were keeping the peace in the name of House Bolton. It's an argument you cannot win.
Yeah, I can't. They kill my family.
Ramsay Snow will be here within the week.
And what would you have us do? Nothing.
I would have us use our heads while they're still attached to our shoulders.
Garrett has lost as much as anyone else within these walls. Maybe you can talk some sense into your uncle.
Garrett's suffered enough already. You ask too much of the boy.
He deserves to be heard. It was his family they killed.
They deserve to die. All of them.
Yeah.
I say we fight.
Ha! Listen to your nephew. He speaks sense.
With what army? Our best men were killed at the Twins, along with our lord.
When we fight
then
our
what's
army.
What's to be done?
Ultimately, it will be for Lord Ethan to decide.
He's just a boy who can barely hold a sword.
Sure.
He knows nothing of how to lead men.
He is the lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this. But I'll accuse you of murder, and us of protecting you.
The boy was just defending himself.
I'm not faulting him for what he did.
I've done nothing wrong.
Yeah.
Not in their eyes.
I didn't
it's
even
just
kill
the excuse
him.
Ramsay Snow would need to put us to the torch and kill us all.
I'd like to see them
But not that other guy.
I'm afraid it's a risk we cannot take, which is why you cannot stay.
What? You're kicking me out?
Cannot stay. Stay. Duncan, the boy has suffered enough.
What?
Where would I go?
The one place beyond the reach of even House Bolton.
You're sending him to the wall?
What?
The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's the only solution. Especially now.
I'm not a criminal.
The house is so vulnerable.
Uncle, you can't send me to the wall. I'm not a criminal.
There'd be nothing we could do to protect you. To stay would bring destruction upon us all. I know that's not what you want. I know
that
it's difficult
sucks.
To understand. But you must think of the house.
I won't put others at risk. I'll go.
I know it doesn't seem fair, but it is what's best.
Oh my god. I can't have bitches. I can't fuck bitches when I go to the wall.
That settles it.
Kinda sucks.
You can have my horse, and I'll see you have plenty of food. But we haven't much time. The White Hills will come looking for you.
Thanks a lot, Uncle. Jaggers.
Word up to me. I'd gladly drive a sword through Lord Whitehill's heart if given a chance. I would. And God's willing, someday I will. But for now, I have House Forrester to consider first. I know you're not a criminal, but Lord Forrester would be proud that you're putting the interests of the house ahead of your own. Many of Lord Forrester's best men have volunteered for the war. His own great uncle was a ranger with the Night's Watch.
I'll do what's best.
Which often isn't what's easiest, but necessary nonetheless.
Still sucks.
I've been waiting for the right moment to tell you.
What? What is it?
It's important. Lord Forrester asked me to give you a message. He said, the North Grove can never be lost.
Sorry, you caught me by surprise. It's not often discussed, if ever.
What is it?
What is the North Grove?
Most don't even know it exists. They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools, and it's better kept that way. You haven't told anyone else, have you?
No.
This is important, Garrett.
Of course not. I told no one.
Well done. Lord Forrester was right to put his trust in you.
If I scumbag, I'm just going to tell everyone.
This will be our secret. But soon, I may need your help.
But
I can't say anything more just yet. Just know the North Grove may very well be vital to the future of this house. But don't breathe a word of it to anyone at the wall. Become a ranger if you can. It will help.
Fine. Well, I will meet Jon Snow. Maybe.
Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Winter's coming.
Remember, you represent House Forrester. Your actions at the wall will reflect the honor and dignity of the house.
I'll be strong.
I know you will.
Garrett, wait!
What? Oh.
Be safe.
Always am. Well, that's a rough start for a beginning of an episode. Kinda sad though. But still awesome. Oh, we eat in forest now. Okay. Change of carrot. Huh.
I couldn't find him. Could you? He hides too well. And if he were smart, he would reveal himself.
I don't like this game anymore. Maybe something happened to him.
Ethan's fine. He's just forgotten this is a game.
I win!
Congratulations, your lordship.
Don't worry. It's just a game, Ryan.
A stupid game. I don't like it.
He was worried you were gone.
I thought we'd never find you again.
Aww. I'm right here. And I promise, I'm not going anywhere.
I wish Mira was here. And Asha. And Roderick.
I do too. But Mira's in King's Landing and...
Can't she come home? I don't want her to die too.
Oh, Lyanna's dying.
Ryan, she's perfectly safe, I promise you.
I don't want Garrett to die either. Maester Old Tengrin said he got sent to the wall. I'll miss Garrett. He was nice.
He'll be fine. Garrett is smart.
No one will tell me what Garrett did, but it must have been serious. I heard Duncan and Sir Roiland talking. They said someone will come here looking for revenge.
Everyone's worried about you, but I'm not. I know you'll protect us.
Who said they're worried about me?
Well, Sir Roiland for one. He says you can't fight very well.
What?
You're just a boy, so...
Sir Roiland forgets himself.
That's Gambit.
I'll have him punished for saying that.
Punished.
What does milksop mean?
I don't know, but I know it's not good.
Ethan, you should let Sir Roiland teach you how to wield a sword, like a man. He taught
this...
Roderick and Asha, and he even showed me how to fight. Properly, I mean.
A lord should know how to fight.
A lord?
Do you remember when we were younger? When we all used to play here? You, me, Roderick, Asha... We'd all be out here for hours.
Yeah. Where was I?
You weren't born yet.
Duh.
We had so much fun. But then, well, then everything changed. Roderick became so serious, the lord in training, and he never smiled anymore. And Asha just got angry at everything. Promise me you won't be like that. Please, just be you. I like you the way you are.
I don't know even what he is, so...
I know a lord has many responsibilities, but you don't need to be like them.
I promise, I won't change.
Good, because I'd rather have a brother than a lord.
You'll have to have both, I'm afraid.
Duh.
once you're the new lord, you can do anything you want.
I suppose.
Not anything.
Everyone will have to do as you say. So I could have all the sweets I want.
If only it were that simple. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted for once.
Should have been nice.
Ethan will be a good lord. A proper lord.
As many as you'd like, yes.
She does
like. Of course. Why not?
Sure.
Lord Ethan, you're needed in the Great Hall at once. Quickly, on your feet.
What's the matter?
Lord Whitehill has arrived, unannounced and certainly unexpected. He's come demanding justice.
Justice?
Can't he meet with Duncan? He is the Castellan.
Stay with us. Please, Ethan.
He's demanding an audience with the Lord. We really must go.
It's your decision. You are the Lord.
If I were Lord, I would command Ethan to stay. With his family.
I have to go, I'm the Lord.
If that's what's required of me.
Very well then.
This isn't going good. Oh, I just promised her I would be a brother.
They showed up unannounced. Lord Whitehill is in a lather. I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they're here?
A business with Garrod. I told him.
Lord Whitehill knows Garrod is a squire to this house. Or was, I suppose.
Is, was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction.
Fine.
Out there, you were decisive and firm. Now do it again with these bastards.
Let's not do something rash. Things are bad enough as it is.
What should I say to him?
Tell him and his men to leave.
Now is not the time to anger Lord Whitehill any more than he already is. He's got five times as many men.
I have no
and
idea what to
of
say.
House Bolton.
All the more reason to stand up for ourselves. Only cowards and dead men roll over.
Oh my.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother. The late Lord Forrester was no friend to me or my house. My only regret is I wasn't there to drive the dagger into his heart myself.
What the fuck?
I've been waiting for this day all my life.
How dare you?
I dare, and I'll do as I damn well please. And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody
You're too fat for bread and salt.
No courtesies. I should have expected as much.
Calm yourself, old man.
You little fuck! That's how you talk to a lord? You foresters have shit on us for generations.
I'm not gonna play nice here.
Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the north now.
Roose Bolton is the warden of the north.
Aye. And we've been his bannermen for five fucking centuries, you cunt.
Lord Ethan, you're losing control of this.
We all serve House Bolton now.
I'm not finished. Maybe if you hadn't been so fucking greedy with the ironwood, things would have been different between us.
You squandered your share.
Our share was taken from us. We had no fucking choice but to harvest what was left.
You went drunk.
What is it you want, Lord Whitehill?
Drunk ass fed man. What?
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business, keeping the king's peace, as his lordship here said, when your man attacked us for no reason.
Hear that? Attacked for no reason.
You murdered.
No reason. You murdered his family.
Then you admit it was your man who killed my men. And a pig
what the hell?
At that. How do you answer for your squire, Lord Ethan? He acted in your name. And you are the lord of this house.
He was defending his family as any man would. But your men murdered them all.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. The soldier's worth 100 of their time.
Oh, shut up.
Where's the fucking coward who killed my men?
He's
not
here.
I know he's here. What have you done with him?
He was sent to the wall.
Who the fuck sent him to the wall? Answer me. Who's the one who did it?
I did.
What? That was my justice to deliver, boy. And you denied me of it. I'm not leaving until I have my justice. Now bring me the coward who did it, or you'll answer to Roose Bolton.
What?
What kind of fucking house is this?
A house of honorable men.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar, Lord Whitehill. Have you forgotten your manners?
Yeah. Asshole.
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering your losses and all. But this is not over.
It is over, and
it's
I say
over
so.
When my son says it is.
This is over, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here. If that displeases you, then I trust you can find the door.
Just go.
That lad may be lord of this house, but Lord Bolton will have the final say. I'll send him a raven letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face and denied me my justice. Then we'll see whose word is law.
Oh, shut up.
You're a craven, Lord Whitehill.
What an asshole. That went well.
I was wrong about your son, my lady.
That went well.
He stood up to him like a true lord.
You were brave, my son. But you'll need to be braver still when Ramsay Snow arrives to see you bend the knee. Prepare a raven. We need to send word to Mira in King's Landing at once. Your sister can help us. Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
Okay, let's look at the coin.
Asher sent me this coin to remember him.
Cool.
What a strange place, Essos.
Yeah.
Ethan made this for me.
Cool. Another. That's great.
Father. Much excitement here in King's Landing for the coming wedding. Lady Marjorie has proven to be quite popular throughout the city. I do wish you and Mother could come. Although I know it would be impossible under the circumstances. I miss all of you, and I look forward to the day you can.
Oh. So sad.
It was very kind of Lady Marjorie to give this to me. It once belonged to Lady Elena. Wonders Made by Man, by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
You will. Maybe.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
Dang, so depressed. Okay, let's go around. Look at the lid.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Open.
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
No, it's fine.
No, it's fine. Come in.
It's probably important. Maybe not, he's just here to clean. I put stuff on the table.
Begging your pardon, lady, but you all right? If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
I'm fine, thank you.
Of course, m'lady.
I'm trusting no one.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
Damn, you look like shit.
You work for Lady Marjorie? I may be wrong, but it seems like you do.
Perhaps you should come back later.
Of course, m'lady.
I don't want to trust him. I trust no one. Ah!
Lady Marjorie.
I know who that
you're
is.
You're early. Okay. I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss.
She's so nice.
From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact. Thank you, my lady. And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. You're very kind, my lady. Of course, Mira, but you must not despair. We will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford.
Yeah.
Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor.
Oh, not again. Oh, this traitor.
She was very pleased with herself. What does she intend to do? She intends to make you miserable, knowing that will make me miserable as well. She demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know. But
what did I do?
She's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her.
You
I wouldn't
bitch.
Ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near. I'll do as you ask, my lady. I knew I could trust you. Humor her. Tell her what she wants to hear.
I do. Oh my god, that's Cersei.
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us.
Great, no private time.
You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another. Good luck.
I didn't do anything. What the fuck? Oh, that's Tyrion. Ooh, it's my favorite character. Okay, let's go.
You can do this.
Okay. Everybody knows she's a bitch, so I have to be really, really nice. Really, 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 really nice.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester. Your Grace.
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Of course.
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet...
And he's still alive.
For centuries, the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark. A house of traitors.
Yes, Your Grace. They are traitors.
The Starks were your liege lord, yet you name them traitors so easily.
What?
I take it this is the kind of loyalty the king can expect from you. If you have any loyalty at all.
I have.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey. If it was me, I'd find it difficult to so quickly forgive the men who killed my father.
But, oh.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned. But now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you?
Of course I would.
Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
Yes, Your Grace. I would do anything.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the war? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms.
Oh, you have to bring that up?
Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
No.
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? Oh. If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north, here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question.
If it's...
No. If your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she
Let
would...
Let the girl answer the question.
I would be true to the king, Your Grace.
Well said. I was beginning to worry you didn't have your priorities straight.
I have to say it.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all
of
King's Landing.
Yeah, waste of time.
My sense is this girl will say almost anything to get what she wants. Which is not very encouraging.
I want to say bitch so much.
I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then, he didn't trust Roose Bolton.
Of course
we only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion. That's very kind of you to say.
Tyrion is the best.
That certainly took courage. to so publicly declare your loyalty to Joffrey for all to hear. Poor Lady Margaery was humiliated.
Yeah.
Although Cersei seemed quite pleased. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I did it for Lady Margaery.
I don't trust the
rather
king.
Odd, if that's what she asked of you. But I'm sure she has your best interests at heart. My sister and I have our differences.
Really?
She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester.
Really?
Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance. And it would infuriate Cersei. Although what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous.
Yeah,
for you
maybe it's not a good
and
idea.
Your house. Are you willing to risk that? It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion.
Can't do that.
But it's a risk I cannot afford.
I admire your discretion. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. Three
Sansa?
Beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival.
Good night, Lord Tyrion.
Just be careful. This is not the North. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
Of course.
Mira, I was worried.
Who is she?
How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing.
That's...
It didn't go very well.
I'm sorry. Cersei is known for being rather...
Bitch.
...difficult. But at least it's over now. Lady Margaery has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding.
The purple wedding!
Of course, you and I are seated way at the back. Here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jaime, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah!
Damn.
What? It's true. And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour, which I doubt is Dornish for wife.
Put it back.
We're just having a bit of fun.
Not fun at all.
It's probably for the best. I've heard he's a bit perverse. Perhaps Lady Margaery could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands. Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like.
Probably horrible.
Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
Oh, hell no.
He does have a certain look about him. And he's always treated Lady Margaery well.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
He's horrible.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden.
This?
Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match. Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing? Well?
I'm sorry, my lady.
Yeah.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful.
Hell no.
The Queen was... pleased by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over.
Me too.
King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree? People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
Yeah, I'm just saying
it's
true.
You learn very quickly. You were brave agreeing to obey the Boltons. That cannot have been easy. I know you must fear what Lord Bolton might do to your family.
I am.
I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important.
I'm gonna ask for help. Maybe it's the right thing.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
I hope. I think.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
I prefer to speak alone.
I prefer to speak with you alone.
It's not good. No offense.
Go on.
Forgive me, my lady. I wouldn't otherwise ask this of you, but my mother insisted. It's about my family.
Ramsay Snow. What would you have me do?
My mother fears our family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. She thought, if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown. I know it's a lot to ask of you. And I wouldn't otherwise, but she insisted.
That is no small request, especially now.
I know, my lady, and I wouldn't ask this of you otherwise.
Please.
But my mother has left me no choice. She insisted.
You gotta help us.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks, and now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire? Joffrey will not look favorably on such a request.
My mother feels it is urgent, my lady. She's unfamiliar with King's Landing and its politics. I hope you can understand that.
She's not gonna do it. Is she?
Very well.
Oh.
I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Okay. Thank you, my lady. I will send a raven to my family at once.
Oof. King's Row, Wolves. What the hell? Oh, calm yourself. Just lost my horse.
Seven elves.
Oh my god.
Let's play a little game, shall we?
No, not him.
Did you
oh my god, not him.
Skins of their enemies as a coat. Not my best work, unfortunately. I suppose I have fallen out of practice. But he didn't make it easy. What with all that bloody noise?
I said to the right and give me to the left.
I thought he'd never stop.
As my father likes to say, a naked man holds few secrets. But the flayed man holds none.
Pity he didn't know your father is the Warden of the North.
Oh, get
he
back.
He does now. How much further is it to these foresters?
A day, my lord. Two at most.
What was that?
Shit. You heard me.
My lord?
Shh. Listen.
No, don't come here.
There. Hear that?
Shit.
I know I heard something.
face.
Never mind.
I should never.
We've wasted enough time. Good. Already.
Thank God. What's that guy that torture? Is that the... They're not coming back? Don't tell me it's that guy who just got his dick cut up. His dick cut up? No, really? Is it? I don't think it's him. No, it's not.
Bloody hell!
Oh my God!
Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership.
Blah, 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 blah.
But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you.
You don't say.
Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise.
And what will they call me?
That is for you to define as the new lord.
Okay, Lord,
These were your Max father's Payne. People to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others. The Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
What the fuck?
We need his judgment.
What did he do?
I've done nothing wrong. I was only trying to survive.
Lord Ethan. Maester.
Maester.
Who is this man?
This Craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed!
What?
We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
You stole from us?
You stole from us? I feared for my life. Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee. It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right!
He speaks true.
I've a family to feed. And not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay? Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone.
Mercy. No.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
We are in this together.
You say that. But it won't be you who's starving come winter.
But don't hit him.
You'll address him as Lord.
Leave him alone.
Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it
is. Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their Lord will not permit it.
We can send him to the war.
Is that the solution to everything? Send men to the war? Are you serious?
I will decide.
I can't kill him.
Take his fingers!
He's a thief! If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please, my lord. My family depends on me.
Show him mercy.
Our house tends to its people. See, this man is paid and his family is fed.
Lord Ethan, you are truly a merciful and noble lord.
My lord, this man is a criminal. A brazen thief.
And I am the lord. I choose to show mercy. Mercy shows greater strength.
Strength shows strength, my lord.
Shut up.
My lord, we must speak about our gold reserves. Soon.
My lord, I thank you for the mercy you've shown me. I will never forget my debt to you and to this house.
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due.
Not just yourself, of course.
It's a lord's duty, so I did it.
You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again.
Yeah.
But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side.
Cool.
Someone you can rely on. No matter the circumstance.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here. The bracer of the sentinel. The badge of office.
Bitch.
Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choices, sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Damn, not an easy job. It's not an easy job. Who should I choose? Who do I like more? I like this guy more. I think I'm gonna talk to him.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As Lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask, who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Would you want to be the sentinel?
More than you can imagine, my lord.
Of course.
With all due respect for Sir Roiland, there's no one better suited to the role than me.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Did I just gave it to him? Oh.
Slash right! That means now!
Duncan, I've decided to name you as my sentinel. Congratulations.
Why, thank you, my lord. I'm honored. But are you sure?
Not entirely. Yes, I am.
Yes, of course. I'm convinced you're the man for the job.
Then I accept. But first, you must summon the small council, my lord, to make it official.
Right. I'll tell Maester Ortengren to do it at once.
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
A turkey leg. Okay, where I'm going? I don't know where I'm going.
Maester?
Yes, Lord. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
Yes, I am.
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
And it was an easy one.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you. Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
I choose this guy.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle? This is reckless.
Oh, shut
Lord
up.
Lord Ethan has made his choice.
I will not pleased. Disappoint you, my lord.
Now, sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here. We've no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me sentinel.
Okay, I'm not gonna listen to him.
I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council.
I will hear from my sentinel.
Yeah, he's my main.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach. Diplomacy can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf. But we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
We all must agree on the plan. We cannot leave until we have a consensus.
Ugh. This is gonna take long.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough!
I'm the king, the lord. We use diplomacy.
My new sentinel favors a certain approach and I agree. I shall use diplomacy with Lord Snow. I would be foolish to pick a fight without negotiating first. I'll offer our allegiance and try to reach a reasonable agreement.
Yeah.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Oh, shut up. I got this under control.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Because I'm the lord, bitch.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival. Invite him into this hall, and meet him face to face. Lord to lord.
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd.
Isn't he?
You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
What?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house.
Oh my gosh, shut up.
You're likely to get us all killed.
Get out.
Get out.
You'll regret that, my lord.
No, I won't. You're just annoying, bitch.
Apologies, my son. I had expected better of him. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall, and we will not offer our ironwood.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house. There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
You want to bring him back?
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it.
I have the will to fight too.
He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be Lord if he returns? Yeah. Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things.
Finger.
And that's not what I want either.
Really?
Asher is volatile. But that is his strength too. Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles.
Wireless.
But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Oh. Of course, your father was furious, but you were in danger and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities, but you do not have that anger inside you.
I'm not like that, but I don't need to be, do I?
No, but you need someone who is standing
beside you. Okay, just invite him to the party.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family, what this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a forester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help
Forrest,
us yet.
Lannister. Stark. Stinta. Maybe I should pick it up. Oh, pick this up. I'm not gonna steal from you. Don't need it.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you might want to know. Thank you. I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't hurt my feelings.
I have to, bitch.
We've known each other for years.
It's a private matter. You shouldn't take it personally.
Well, I did. I thought there was trust between us. Friends don't hold secrets from one another. Now Lady Marjorie thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion very much.
She does?
Sarah, I... My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
What happened?
Are you all right, my lady?
Oh, she's not all right. She's freaking mad.
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
No.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Nothing I said could cheer him.
I'm so sorry, my lady. I should never have asked you for the council.
That was wrong with me. Damn.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
Her dress.
I'm sorry, my lady.
He ripped her dress. Not her perfectly new dress.
Soon I will be queen. And maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family. If you'll excuse me, my lady.
Milady.
What the?
Begging your pardon, milady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been there?
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room.
What do you want? I can't trust no one.
I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can I trust you? There are spies everywhere in King's Landing.
Which is why you must trust me, milady. You need allies.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who... People who'd be willing to help you.
Maybe I should trust. I don't trust people. What are you looking at?
Where's Sir Roiland? He should be here. The man values pride more than honor. We'll do without him. And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us. But I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men stand ready to act if needed.
I hope so.
Yeah.
You made the right decision, my lord.
This is not going well. Oh, not that guy again. And not that guy.
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton, son of Roose Bolton? Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority.
What the hell?
That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
Lord Ramsay, welcome to Ironwrath.
Aren't you the little lord?
Oh my god.
Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Iron.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much. Don't know what's so special about it.
No one can match our skill.
Is that so? Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn...
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently.
Things are going well.
Look at that. More foresters.
Lord Ramsay.
Come out where I can see you.
Oh, he's shy. Or scared.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
Lord Ramsay, I understand you've come here for assurance of our fealty.
Fuck fealty. We came here for justice.
We'll get to your justice. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father. Lord Bolton, Warden of the North.
Oh, hell no.
Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it?
A little bit.
Here's the thing. I don't care about... about your loyalty.
Okay.
The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the king. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
No, Lord Ramsay.
That's a good little...
You can't trust her, Forrester.
Shut up.
They murdered our men.
It was a Forrester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One bolt.
Lord Whitehill is a liar. That's not how it happened.
Lad? A liar? He's a Whitehill.
Just look at him while
then
he looks at
me. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army.
Oh, shut up.
That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone.
What?
The Whitehills will be taking control of your Ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What? The Ironwood? But...
No.
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them, you cut them down.
We have loyal craftsmen who make the finest weapons. The Whitehills have no such craftsmen. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have
to. Yeah.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares
no.
better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironwrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
Whitehill men? Never.
It's already done.
What?
You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
You cannot be serious.
Whitehills have no place here,
lads. Do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Duncan, don't.
Look at this, little Forrester. You're not frightened, are you?
Leave him alone.
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
Leave my sister alone!
I have an idea. You'll come.
No!
With me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well. I suppose you can stay.
Duh.
Aren't you the bold lord?
Oh my god.
What have you done?
But I don't want.
What the fuck?
Far too much trouble.
Ethan! Ethan! No! No! No!
No.
Even though you did bend the knee.
My son.
I think we've come to an understanding.
No.
I certainly feel better about all this.
What have you done?
However, the Foresters need to keep their end of the bargain.
Oh my god.
Take the boy of your war.
No!
Kill him if they give you any trouble.
Brian.
What the fuck?
Lovely meeting all of you.
What an asshole.
Somebody help him!
Fetch the maester quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mother!
Stop!
Don't let him take me!
Let him go!
Oh my fucking god!
Stop it!
You can do it!
Do something!
Ethan?
My son.
Holy motherfucking shit. Oh my god. Ooh. Oh my god, that was so...
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
Really?
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties.
Jon Snow.
Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
What the hell? Oh my god! Oh my god! Okay, you want to stay with... Miss... Okay, you want to stay with one. 73.2% towards the king. Of course you did. It's fucking suicide. Look at you went 40% for Frida, you and Stephen, Big Duncan as Sentinel. Met Rams in a great hall. Okay. Ooh. That was great. Oh my god. That was so great. Thank you guys for watching. Please leave a like or subscribe or commentary or whatever. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace.